Hi everyone, welcome to Seasons of Music. My name is Christopher Ayer. Well, you've asked for it, so in this episode we'll be featuring a few more of the performances of the Love and Bone Choir and of Bernadette Scott. So sit back, relax and enjoy. Hi everyone, welcome once again to an episode of Seasons of Music. As I said before, this episode will be a little different than usual, where we'll be sharing more of the performances of the Love Movement. In the next clip, we'll be featuring Bernadette singing one of her more memorable songs. So, enjoy.
Be dreaming, oh, am I really lying here with you? Baby, you take me in your arms, and though I'm wide awake, I know my dream is coming true. It must be magic, the way I hold you when the night just seems to fly. Easy for you to take me to a star. Heaven is that moment when I look into your eyes. And
hi everyone, I'm sure you enjoyed that clip of Bernadette singing again. You know, we really miss her beautiful voice. But you know, the group was formed in 1972, and you know, I was looking back at a magazine, that a pullout that we had done in our 40th anniversary, and the headline was "The Love Movement's Evolution: Yesterday, Today, and Tomorrow." And it says, "The Love Movement was formed in 1972 when Bernadette Scott, seeing the need, decided to use her God-given talents and those of 15 girls from her church choir to raise funds for the underprivileged and at the same time spread the good news of the gospel through music." So in this next clip, we will feature songs from that era featuring the Love Movement's senior choir.
Nothing special, in fact, I'm a bit of a bore. If I tell a joke, you've probably heard it before. But I have a talent, a wonderful thing, 'cause everyone listens when I start to sing. I'm so grateful and proud. All I want is to sing it out loud. So I say thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be? When did it all start? Who found out that nothing can capture a heart like a melody can? Well, whoever it was, I'm a fan. So I say thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be without a song? Or that's what are we? So I'd say thank you for the music, for giving it to me. I've been so lucky. I am the girl with golden hair. I want to sing it out to everybody. What a joy, what a life, what a chance. Thank you for the music, the songs I'm singing. Thanks for all the joy they're bringing. Who can live without it? I ask in all honesty, what would life be?
In 1982, the Love Movement celebrated their 10th anniversary concert called The Memory of Love. You know, and in this program, you know, I have these programs I've collected over the years, so people, my children think I'm crazy about it. But anyway, I like to look back because in the foreword written by Maurice Connor and Father Winston Joseph, Neo said, love must be the reason. The name of this song was the inspired title of the first show put on by the Love Movement 10 years ago. Indeed, must have been the reason that has kept the group together for 10 years. Love of people and love of the music. You know, and Memory of Love was offered up as a thanksgiving to God, our Father, for the graces bestowed on the group. And they gave praise and honor to His Blessed Mother for the protection. So this next clip will feature the Love Movement. As we had done, this will be the Country Moods, which will feature songs like Jambalaya, Georgia, and Lucille. So, the country section of Memory of Love.
Happy fun on the Shh.
You know, having so much fun going through all these articles and clippings of the evolution of love movement and where we have come from. And, you know, in this article, you know, it talks about in the 90s, the youth outreach program was formed. And in it, it says that Burnett was inspired to use the love movement to reach out to the nation's youth and to make a real difference in their lives. And the Love Movement Outreach Program was formally launched in September 1991. So in this next clip, we'll feature the Love Movement Youth Outreach Program.
Thank you.
You know, it always amazes me how Burnett has been able to include the word love in all of the concerts. You know, looking back at this, you have the love of another kind. You have the reason for love, or reason to love. A love story. An amazing love. And the list goes on. Call to love. A legacy of love. And finally, at our 40th anniversary, an everlasting love, because love is the reason for the love movement. So we are once again feature another one of our clips featuring the love movement.
Time seemed to move faster now. The days rushed ahead. Voices that had blessed his coming fell silent. They were replaced with angry shouting. It was the shouting of men whose power was threatened by a kingdom they didn't understand. The days grew shorter as the nights grew longer and darker.
During his last evening on earth, Jesus and his disciples shared a final meal. He warned them that the Prince of Darkness was coming. "He has no hold on me," Jesus said, "but the world must learn that I do exactly as my Father commands."
Under the cloak of darkness, one friend would betray his master, another would deny him. A secret midnight trial gave way to another at dawn. An angry mob, blinded by fear and suspicion, called for his execution. And Jesus Christ, the sinless man, was sentenced to die for the sake of mankind.
The light of the world crucified for the darkness of the world.
He was a man of sorrows, acquainted with our grief. A man despised and rejected, surely we esteemed him not. Nothing to make us desire him, beauty nor majesty. Not one attracted unto him, yet he took up our infirmities, bore the sorrow and the suffering. He was a man of sorrows, acquainted with our grief. A man despised and rejected, surely we esteemed him not. Nothing to make us desire him, beauty nor majesty. Not one attracted unto him, yet he took up our infirmities, all the sorrow and the suffering. He was pierced for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities, and wounded for us. For good man of sorrows,
led as a lamb to the slaughter, afflicted and oppressed.
This man who'd done no violence never spoke his own defense. Cut off from the land of the living, so stricken for my sin. Assigned a grave with the wicked, for the will of my suffering. Guilt the end of all his offering.
And though his soul suffered greatly, the Lord shall prolong his days.
after 50 years of service to the community and to the lives of others, the Lumpen Choir has always been played a major part in the nation's building. So, you know, I look back at our 40th anniversary magazine, and a quotation from Isaiah 61, verse 1 to 3 really describes the love movement. And it says, "The Spirit of the Lord Yahweh is upon me, because Yahweh has anointed me to bring good news to the poor. He has sent me to bind up broken hearts, to proclaim liberty to the captives, freedom to those languishing in prison, to announce the year of Yahweh's favor and the day of vengeance of our God, to give comfort to all who grieve, to comfort those who mourn in Zion, and give them a garland instead of ashes, oil of gladness instead of mourning, and a garment of praise instead of despair." And this scripture really has encouraged and helped all of us in the love movement to remain faithful to His call. So, just looking back 50 years of healing hearts, changing lives, one note at a time, the love movement has really grown into an institution that many of us could be proud of. There you have it, folks. Another episode of Seasons of Music featuring the Love Movement family of choirs. It's a pleasure you joining me today, and look forward to seeing you at our next episode. Bye.